Good morning, everyone. I hope you all are fine at home. Do you all remember what we did yesterday? We did subtraction of four-digit number with four digits, with grouping and without regrouping. Again, I have a small example with me of a four-digit number with four digits with regrouping. After that, I will show you how we can check the answers. Sometimes it happens during you're sitting in an examination hall, a question comes, you write the answer. Sometimes you're not 100% sure whether the answer is right or not. So I will show you a method by which we can check the answer, whether the answer we have obtained is right or not. Is it clear? So let us start the class. So I have a number 5869. It is a four-digit number. We will subtract this from a number 7150. When this word from is written, it means what? We will write this 7150 on the top. The greater number is on the top and the smaller number is below. Is it clear? So let us start the subtraction. We start our subtraction always from the ones place. But in ones place, we have 0 and 9. That we have already learned in a previous class. How do we borrow from this? We will regroup the tens and the ones place. See, 5 tens and 0 ones. We will regroup the 5 tens and the 0 ones. When we regroup the 5 tens and 0 ones, how will we regroup it? 5 tens will become 4 tens and 0 will become 10. How 0 will become 10? We will borrow from 5. 5 will become 4 and your 0 will become 10. Now we can subtract 10 and 9. 10 minus 9 is what? 1. Now let's move on to the tens place. Can we subtract 4 and 6? No, because 4 is a smaller number and 6 is a greater number. Now what we have to do? We have to regroup the hundreds and the tens place. See, in the hundreds place we have 1. So 100 and 4 tens. We have to regroup the 100 and the 4 tens. How do we regroup the 100 and the 4 tens? 100 will become 0 hundred and 4 tens will become 14 tens. How? See, this one will give away its 1 to the tens place. So 10 will become 14 and your hundreds place will become 0. Now let us subtract 14 and 6. 14 minus 6 is what? 14 minus 6 is 8. So 14 minus 6 tens is 8 tens. Now let's move on to the hundreds place. Hundreds place we have 0 and 8. We cannot subtract 0 and 8. So what we have to do? We have to regroup the thousands place and the hundreds place. How will we regroup? In the thousands place we have 7,000 and in the hundreds place we have 0. Now let's group the 7,000s place and the 0 hundreds place. How? 7 will give away its 1 to the hundreds place. This will become 6 and this will become 10. Now we can minus 10 and 8. 10 minus 8 is what? 2. And 6 minus 5 is what? 6 minus 5 is 1. What is the answer you got? You got the answer 1, 2, 8, 1. This was the subtraction of a 4-digit number with a 4-digit number. Now I am going to show you how we can check this answer. See, we've already got the answer. That is 1, 2, 8, 1. Now we have to check the answer. How do we check the answer? What is this? This is your minuend. This is your subtrahend, as already been taught in your previous classes. And this is your difference. Now what we have to do? There is a formula for this. What is the formula? Your formula is minuend is equal to difference plus the subtrahend. Is it clear? Difference minuend is equal to the difference plus the subtrahend. Now what is the minuend out here? Minuend out here is 7150. Clear? And what is the difference you obtain? Difference obtained is 1281. And what is your subtrahend? Your subtrahend is 5869. Is it clear? You have written the minuend, the difference and the subtrahend. This was already given to you. Difference you have found out, the minuend and the subtrahend was given to you. Now let us solve. See, 7150 is equal to what? Let us add 5869 and 1281. Let us add. What do we get? 9 plus 1 is what? 9 plus 1 is 10. 6 plus 1 is 7 and 7 plus 8 is what? 15. Is it clear? Now let's add the hundreds place. 8 plus 1 is 9 and 9 plus 2 is 11. Is it clear? Now let's move on to the thousands place. 5 plus 1 is 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. What answer you got? 7150 is equal to 7150. It means what? Your answer is right. Is it clear? During an exam time, to be 100% sure whether your answer is right or wrong, you can check it by this method. Minuend is equal to difference plus subtrahend. Minuend is already given in the question. Difference is the answer that you have obtained. You can plus with the subtrahend. When you add the subtrahend and the difference, what you get the answer. It means your answer is right. I hope this concept is clear with you. How you can check your answers and how you can regroup and do your subtraction. I hope it is clear. Now we will meet in the next class.